ONE Championship was back in Manila for one of the greatest nights in Philippine martial arts history. In a clash of legends, former ONE lightweight world champion Edward Falayong faced off against four-time world champion Eddie Alvarez in the ONE lightweight world Grand Prix semifinal. Both athletes stepped in to replace former tournament contenders who were forced to drop out due to injuries.
Edward Falayong, the former ONE lightweight world champion. Eddie Alvarez, former UFC and Bellator world champion. Wild hooking punches from both men, but Alvarez may have drawn the short straw on that exchange. Overhand right from Alvarez, trying to lock on the guillotine early here. The wushu striking of Falayong. Hands like slabs of granite, and the leg kicks are thumping. But Alvarez can brawl, can get on the inside and make it a dogfight, make it vicious. The turning back kick from Falayong. He goes to the middle section. Gotta watch the turning liver kicks, gotta watch the cutting side kicks.
I like that left hook of Falayong right now. It's really trying to find a home on Eddie's chin. You can see him testing it, but Eddie says he wants to test Falayong's chin. Foliang's been knocked out tremendously in some of his past matches, and Eddie wants to test that. That movement fading already.
Falayong hooks the punch, then goes the uppercut off the right hand. A high round kick, the spinning back fist, the outside leg kick from Falayong. Putting together the combinations early on is Edward Falayong of the Philippines.
Like those fans call for Eddie.
In a ONE Flyweight World Grand Prix semi-final clash, one of the pound-for-pound greatest of all time and 12-time world champion, Demetrious Johnson, took on Japanese rival, Tatsumitsu Wada.
Much appreciation for the man regarded as the greatest of all time as Wada climbs the back.
Wow, what a sneaky back take from Tatsumitsu Wada. That was beautifully done.
The figure four wrapped around the body of Johnson.
Now he's able to get out. Now he's able to slide in, circle around. Now he's ended up on top. This is very important in the minds of the judges.
Groundhouse kick from TJ to the upper right ribcage, glancing right hand. They clinch up, gut munching knee, tries to fold him in half. Now we see slowly lifting the mercury, rising the temperature here of Demetrious Johnson.
Easy double leg takedown as he changed levels.
TJ postures up, Wada locks down the wrists. TJ wants some ground and pound, threads the elbow. Takedown here from TJ.
TJ starts dropping some ground and pound. He can start moving ahead on the judges' scorecards.
3 minutes remaining in this second semifinal.
He wears you out right up until that last minute, and that's when he finds that submission victory. Oh, this is dangerous for Wada. Beautiful roll through as he ends up on top. Nice scrambling from Demetrious.
Your winner by unanimous decision, Demetrious Johnson!
Demetrious Johnson advances to the final. Johnson takes the winner's medal back to the U.S.
The second of the ONE Flyweight World Grand Prix semifinals faced Team Lakai phenom Danny Kingyad against the always exciting Australian, Reese McLaren.
Look out for the wushu. on Nguyen. McLaren driving double leg takedown, gets it early. Can he keep Nguyen down?
Nguyen was doing a good job of preventing the pass and a good job of getting back up and reversing the position. You can see if McLaren can get under that chin with his right arm, that's when that choke is going to sink in. And there's the turn.
Oh,
into
top
the guard.
Position! Top position for the king! They're going bananas! Trying to hunt the arm, Reece McLaren, and the king! Can he get some strikes? He's on his feet! Can he stay there? This place is going nuts! And now a chance for the Wushu strikes, and McLaren another takedown! Straight back to his feet goes Nguyen, like a jack in the box. There's a left hook, there's a wild right hand, there's a turning back kick. The mighty roar inside the Mall of Asia Arena. Booming right hand, there's the outside leg kick. For the Filipino. And here comes a grounded pound. McLaren back to his feet. Uppercut from Nguyen.
This is Danny Kingad's moment as Danny Kingad goes in for the takedown.
Oh, Danny Kingad takes down the BJJ black belt. How do you do? Hooks the leg here, Nguyen. And McLaren goes for the ride. Side control, he cuts the hip in, drops the elbow, and there's another one. The ground and pound from the king. This place is erupting. Knees now to the body of McLaren, to the arm of McLaren. Elbows again to the orbital go the fists.
The winner by split decision.
Following a decisive victory over Liam Harrison, Thai star Rodlek PK Sanchai Muay Thai Gym faced off against Scotland's Andrew Miller in a bantamweight Muay Thai clash.
A kick there was more of a punt kick from Mad Dog Miller, almost got countered with the right hand. Miller evades the left hook. You see Rodlek quickly skips across to his left to cut off the ring movement.
Miller can't stand there if that allowed Rodlek to tee off on him.
You see the reddening of the thighs there of the Scotsman. Rodlek goes to the body, then the uppercut elbow from the Thai. Inside leg kick from Rodlek. Left hook to the right hand. Look for the power side, the right side. It's a short popping overhand right there from Rodlek. Oh, smack back! He caught him with a short right hand. Smack back to the kisser. Andrew Miller's down. He's on rubber legs. He's doing the chicken dance. And it's over. Rodlek's done it again.
In a spectacular showdown, former ONE Flyweight World Champion Jeihei Eustachio went up against Japan's Yuya Wakamatsu.
Eustachio, the former world champion. Wakamatsu, a cagey character full of tricks. You never know what Wakamatsu is going to throw. Eustachio, a brilliant wushu stylist. Look out for the fast hands, look out for the side kicks, look out for the spinning back fists on Jeihei Eustachio.
One thing we know Wakamatsu is going to throw is that giant right hand he's got. Utilized it beautifully against Demetrious Johnson, against Danny Kingad. Nice and light on his feet, bouncing in and out. Jeihei's nice and relaxed. There he goes, chopping at the legs now with that wushu style sidekick.
Right hand right from Jeihei, and lethal left hand just missed the target for Eustachio. This crowd on the edge of their seats expecting something extraordinary from Eustachio.
And his chin's a little bit tucked there. You can see when he's moving backwards, he starts to pop that chin up. That right hand lands on the chin, though.
High up on the balls of his feet here is Yuya Wakamatsu. Left hook, right hand from Wakamatsu. Didn't have the distance. Overhand right from Yostakio, going for the headache maker. Yostakio edging forward, gets out of the way, just evades the left hand of Wakamatsu. Body shot from Wakamatsu. Turning back kick from Yostakio. Now, what the Wushu guys from Team Lakai will tend to do with that spinning back kick is to aim it towards the liver of the opponent. So just around below the right rib cage, towards the stomach area, the large target that is only partly protected by the ribs, being the liver. It's tucked away. Tip kick. Oh, this one's over. That is huge.
South Korean star Dae-sung Park scored the biggest win of his mixed martial arts career to formally announce himself as the latest contender to emerge in ONE Championship's packed lightweight division. The ONE Warrior Series contract winner defeated former ONE Lightweight World Champion Hanario Benario via unanimous decision after three relentless rounds of action. Daiichi Takenaka picked up the biggest victory of his career in a thrilling bantamweight mixed martial arts battle with Leandro Issa. After a pair of back-and-forth rounds, the Shudo featherweight champion rallied in the third stanza for a highlight reel TKO.
Beautiful skip through Superman punch to drop Issa.
Here comes Takenaka. Top position now for the Japanese athlete. Is Brodinho in trouble? Referee right on top of it, Kim Ching. There's a knee. There's another knee. Here comes Takenaka. Brodinho not answering.
Issa's got to move. Issa can't stand there. He's trying to go deep.
Oh, it's good night. It's over. Takenaka gets the win.
Takenaka improved his record to an impressive 12-1-1. And elevated himself into the upper echelon of the bantamweight division. James Nakashima sealed the biggest victory of his career as the undefeated American ripped through Japanese mixed martial arts legend Yushin Okami to push his record to an amazing 12-0.
Oh, smack bang! Okami got tagged. That was out of the Petrosian playbook. Beautiful left hand from Nakashima, looking for the finish now. And Okami got dropped.
Nice sneaky punches here from Nakashima as he's going around the corner here to do damage on Okami.
Your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, James Nakashima.
C.A. Bin silenced the crowd and scored a technical unanimous decision victory over Team Lakai's Edward Kelly. The end came abruptly in the second round when C.A. inadvertently hit Kelly on the back of the head. Kelly was given the mandatory 5 minutes recovery time, but he could not continue, and the match went to the judges, who then handed the Chinese warrior the victory. In the co-main event, ONE Flyweight Muay Thai World Champion Jonathan Haggerty defended his world title for the first time. Having overcome all the odds to defeat Muay Thai legend Samae Gyeong Hadao to claim the world title, he next faced the toughest opponent of his career, superstar Muay Thai World Champion Rodtang Jitmuangnon.
Haggerty just kept pouring it on.
Haggerty, and you see Rodtang now. He'll start the showboating. He'll start the theater, and he'll start the heavy silvers. You see Rodtang trying to walk him down now. He wasn't doing that the first two rounds. Is Haggerty going to stand and go toe-to-toe? Is he going to play that game? Rodtang goes to the liver. Haggerty felt that one. Double forearms guard is high. Oh, Haggerty tags it. jerk in and out of the phone booth. Smack bang goes Haggerty. And Rodtang thrusts out the lead leg. Goes to the waist. Haggerty counts as body shot. High kick. Another liver shot. Jab from Haggerty. Gotta get off the ropes though. Gotta get off the ropes though. Gotta get off the ropes. Rodtang goes downstairs. Outside leg kick from Rodtang. Left hook. Haggerty fires the elbow. Goes down the center corridor. A beautiful catch and dunk there from Rodtang.
Oh, that pressure.
A hooking punches and the power of the 4 ounce gloves. You see Haggerty trying to slice and dice and fillet there with the uppercut elbow.
Oh, he hurt.
The liver shots hurt him. The liver shots hurt the champion. Drops it, the big kibosh, and Haggerty goes down. Now he's gone, incredible hope.
And new ONE Featherweight World Championship.
Strawweight powerhouse Miao Li Tao put his dominant wrestling and grappling game on show against Thailand's Pong Sari Mitsatit. Both men started out looking to strike, but Miao was clearly just looking for an opportunity to take the action to the canvas. He did just that with a powerful double leg takedown inside the first 30 seconds. Once the action hit the ground, Miao went to work and controlled the grappling exchanges with his smothering top game as he worked for a submission. It was a pattern that ran throughout the contest as Miao swiftly took Mitsatit down in each of the 3 5-minute rounds and then kept command of the contest on the mat. The result was a formality as Miao was awarded the victory to claim the 12th win of his career. Ayaka Miura took another massive step toward a shot at the ONE Women's Strawweight World Championship. The Japanese star defeated the former ONE Strawweight World title challenger, Samara Santos, with her trademark scarfhold Americana. The Brazilian knew her opponent's plan of attack and tried her best to evade Miura's favorite submission. But Miura, a third-degree judo black belt, locked up the hold in the opening stages of round two.
She's trying to wrap up that arm, sink in that key lock from that scarfhold position.
And she got it. It's yet another victory by submission for Ayaka Miura.
Muhammad Ayman looked sharp with his strikes and grappling defense as he shut down Tsunoda's attempts to turn this contest into a wrestling match and found a home for his quick punching combinations. The Indonesian bantamweight got his rival to the mat on the third attempt, but he could not do much before Ayman popped back up. Once he was back on his feet, he began to find a home for his left hook and opened up with some high kicks. Ayman picked up the pace and increased the pressure in the final frame as he started to initiate the exchanges and land strikes in combination as he exploded forward. After 15 minutes, all three judges' cards went to Ayman, which gave him the win by unanimous decision and improved his professional mixed martial arts record to 6-3. ONE Featherweight World Champion Martin Nguyen continued to create his legacy by putting his world title on the line against Japanese juggernaut Koyomi Matsushima. Nguyen was coming off a dramatically impressive knockout victory of martial arts veteran and former ONE Featherweight World Champion Narantungalog Jidama, and he knew he had to ride the wave of victory in order to be the greatest featherweight on the planet.
That was a beautiful double leg takedown from Matsushima right there.
Elbows from Martin Nguyen, the champion, back to his feet, avoids the round kick. Matsushima had an opportunity. Nguyen a little too slick, though, a little too evasive. Takes him for a ride, does Matsushima. Shoots him for a low single, Sakuraba style. There's the high knee! Ground and pound now for the champion.
Big shots landed from the champion as Matsushima gets that single leg.
Oh, there's a nice hooking right hand from Nguyen, then goes to the orbital. Body shot from Nguyen, rips it into the liver. Double jab. Nguyen wants to lock him in the corner, throw the heavy artillery. Oh, he catches him with a hook! Matsushima taking some heavy blows. Oh, cracking roundhouse kick. He tags him again. Matsushima in a whole world of hurt. Martin Nguyen teeing off at him like a golf course. Here he goes. He's battering away. He's battering away.
Might be it.
Is it going to be the end? Okay, Marty, let's go party. Martin Nguyen, fantastic. A superb performance and put an absolute shellacking on Matsushima at the end. And doing so once again in highlight reel fashion, as he always seems to do.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.